Good evening. We are going to begin today's board meeting. It is March 1st, 2017, and it is 7 o'clock. We will convene the regular meeting of the Board of Education. If you would stand, Mr. Aho, would you please call the roll?
Mr. Curtis?
Here.
Mr. Solera?
Here.
Mrs. Davis?
Here.
Mr. Felber?
Here.
Mrs. Turl Waldron?
Here.
All right, we are all here. Would you all stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
There we go. Finally got it in order. I think I got a little shaken up because of all the gale force winds this morning. good evening and welcome students, staff, and families of Samuel Bissell and R.B. Chamberlain Middle School. I'm Mark Curtis, and it is my privilege to be your board president. Although spring isn't here yet, you couldn't tell by the ever-predictable, or at least ever-unpredictable weather of Northeast Ohio, as just recently we're enjoying 75-degree temperatures, and just last week and this morning, well, you know, here we are. But alas, we're back to reality. Supposedly, maybe later on this evening, we'll be wearing heavier coats and turning the heat back on. So we'll see what the weather has in store. I'd like to offer congratulations to our Lady Tigers high school basketball team and Coach Julie Solis on a great season as they finished as co-champions of the Suburban League. They also won this past Monday, so they'll continue on in the playoffs. In addition, I want to offer congratulations to Tiana Elder for finishing first place in bowling in Canton, Ohio. She is also headed to the state bowling championship, or at least state bowling competition, on March 10th, so we wish her luck in her endeavors. Finally, if you weren't able to witness the Twinsburg City School District Orchestra as they played with Mark Wood, you missed one of the most amazing shows of the year. There were flashing lights, booming strings, and a rocking crowd that capped off a performance for the ages. But wait, there's more. I want to invite you to come out and support our schools this Friday as the Blue Ribbon Committee sponsors a basketball fundraiser featuring Twinsburg staff members at the high school at 7 o'clock. We promise it will be fun and enjoyable evening for everyone. There will also be another community meeting, community forum, March 20th at the library. So please come out, and I encourage others to attend as well. We know that there are many questions, so we want to make sure that we make concerted effort to ensure that our electorate is informed and getting accurate information. We also have a website where information about the levy can also be obtained, and that's www.twinsburglevy, that's one word, .com. www.twinsburglevy.com. Finally, after having gathered feedback throughout Ohio, the Ohio Department of Education has released its draft proposal for compliance of the Federal Every Student Succeeds Act. ESSA, as it is often referred to, is the reauthorization of the former No Child Left Behind. This new law is supposed to allow states to have more flexibility in how we conform to the federal law. However, Ohio's most recent version suggests things will be the status quo. So although there was significant feedback to scale back the amount of standardized testing that our district and other districts throughout Ohio has incurred, Ohio has chosen to maintain the current process. And we strongly encourage you as parents and taxpayers to reach out to make your voices heard. Myself, as well as this administration, the superintendent, as well as superintendent's group, have already submitted a letter hoping that they adhere or at least hear the concerns that have been made throughout the state. But we encourage you to reach out to Senator Frank LaRose and also Christine Rogner to voice your concerns around this matter. Every little bit helps, so we hope that you take a moment to express your views. So without further delay, I will turn the meeting over to our superintendent, Mrs. Powers.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis. Good evening, Board of Education. As always, so great to see all of our families here and our Tigers, and so nice to recognize all the wonderful things that happen every day in our schools. Interesting start to the morning, wasn't it? I don't know about you, but being woken up at about 5:25 by sirens is not a good thing. So thank you for understanding our need to do the two-hour delay today. Fortunately, the storm passed by without much worry to most of us, but I know that that was a scary start in the morning, and I know that sometimes frightens our kids, and so I do apologize for that, but hopefully that might be the last of it. We don't know. I don't know about you, but the daffodils are up in my yard, so that means spring is here, right? We'll see. You know, I was just saying to Mr. Welker here, the incoming kindergarten class is the class of 2030. 2030, can you imagine? And so I just wanted to announce this evening that tomorrow night is a pretty important evening over at Wilcox Primary School, because it's the kindergarten parent kickoff meeting for the class of 2030. That's a lot. Wow. So beginning March 20th, parents of our students that are the incoming Tigers, the class of 2030, and those would be children who will be turning 5 years of age before August 1st, 2017, are asked to visit our district website, and the address, in case you're not aware, is www.twinsburg.k12.oh.us. Then you click on the For Parents tab, and then you scroll down to a link called Registration Information. Once you're there, you're going to be asked to create an account, and then you'll be asked to complete some pre-registration information. And once that is finished, you'll be able to make an appointment for the actual kindergarten registration days, which are this year May 9th, 10th, and 11th. And thanks to our partnership with the City of Twinsburg, this will be the third year that kindergarten registration will be held up at the Twinsburg Community Center, which is located behind R.B. Chamberlain Middle School. So as always, if you have any questions, especially our new parents who are for the first time maneuvering all of this, I know it's scary and exciting at the same time, you can always feel free to give the board office a call or Wilcox Primary School, and our staff there is always so excited to greet our newest Tigers, and we want to make sure that our new parents have all the information they need to start off their child's school experience in a very positive way. So welcome aboard, class of 2030. Wow, I can't believe it. So as Mr. Curtis has indicated, he actually stole my whole script here, so I'm going to go rather quickly through the rest of this. I saw Mrs. Stork at the board office yesterday. Mrs. Stork is the president of our Twinsburg Orchestra Boosters, and thanks to their dedication and their hard work last week, we had Mark Wood here at the high school a couple days. If you don't know who he is, he was one of the founding members of the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. So if you enjoy that kind of music, you know that he is a string violinist and is just a remarkable man. He believes in arts education and the importance of that in a fully developed child, and he spoke about that a lot, interspersed through his music and his concert last week. But my favorite part of the concert, honestly, was watching our kids perform with him, knowing that you have this star. He performs with Celine Dion. He performs with these stars all over the world. And to have him on our stage and our students being able to perform with him, there was nothing like that. And as Mrs. Stork said to me yesterday, this was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for many of our students. And to be able to provide that opportunity here for our Twinsburg Tigers was just phenomenal. So again, we thank the Twinsburg Orchestra Boosters for bringing Mark Wood to Twinsburg High School. And it wasn't just the high school students, it was our orchestra program in grades 4 through 12, and just a remarkable event. And I spoke with him after the concert, just a genuinely nice person and just really believes in arts education. And Board of Education, he was very complimentary to you for the fact that you support arts education. That's one of the great things about our school district. And said to me, if there's anything that he can do for us moving forward, just to give him a call. So just fabulous. Last night, we had a wonderful program at the high school, and we celebrated Black History Month with a culminating activity, a program called Who Are We? And this was a program actually created by our students at the high school, and it was under the direction of Ms. Tanya Johnson, a number of staff members, and a small army of parents and community members that came together for this wonderful performance to celebrate Black History Month. I also want to thank Mr. Ryan Bonitz and our jazz band at Twinsburg High School who were a part of the program yesterday. And once again, watching our kids perform on the stage, now in a different way, just there's nothing like it. And they were so proud of themselves afterwards. That was the best part, I think, at the very end when they just knew that they did this, and they did it so well, and worked together for this. And nothing like watching kids learn. It's just great. Also, congratulations to Tiana Elder, who's on her way next weekend to the OHSAA Tiger, it's actually the state bowling tournament, and she's the only one that will be proceeding to that level. We are so very excited for her. Her mom is delighted. We'll be going with her to Columbus with our coach, and we congratulate her. And of course, you heard Mr. Curtis mention about our Lady Tiger basketball team. They play tomorrow night at Euclid High School. They'll be taking on the Solon Commons. This evening across the street, once again, the Powers House is divided because our Tigers are playing the Aurora Greenmen in a sectional playoff game, so we'll see what happens there. See if I'll be making dinner tomorrow. It depends. And then finally, we're proud of the six members of the Twinsburg High School Tiger wrestling team who are advancing now to sectionals, out of sectionals, and will compete at the North Canton Hoover tournament this Saturday, March 4th. So we wish all of our students the very best of luck. We have so many great kids here and so many things that happen to support the students in the classroom and all these wonderful, wonderful things that happen outside the classroom. And then finally, just a shout out to our Twinsburg Vocal Music Boosters. Last weekend, we hosted the North Coast Show Choir Invitational. What a fabulous gathering of some of the very best show choirs, not only in our state. We had a group here from Alabama. We had a group here from Connecticut, and many from the state of Ohio, and the very best in show choirs. And it was a fundraiser to support our three show choirs, Great Expectations, the RBC Singers, and the Mood Swingers, which is our all-female show choir at the high school. And the dollars that were earned through the efforts of our Twinsburg Vocal Music Boosters will support our show choirs now moving forward. This coming weekend, if the board approves it, the kids are going to Connecticut to perform there in a national show choir competition. So that is the caliber of students and the kinds of groups that we have in our school district. And I just want to support our parents and our community members for their continued support of our kids. This doesn't happen by whim. This happens because our parents here are supporting the kids. We have a great staff and a community that supports what we do here every day. So thank you so very much for that. So speaking about exciting kids and things to celebrate and students to celebrate, I know Mrs. Johnson is always excited, and I had the opportunity this week to spend some time with her at her building. It was a great joy for me yesterday, and I would like to invite you forward to celebrate some students and the Students of the Month from Samuel Bissell Elementary School. Okay, and Mr. Curtis is going to help us with some pins. And boys and girls, so this is how it works if you haven't been here before. So I'll be reading the names this evening and saying who your classroom teacher is. And then when you come on up, if you could shake Mr. Curtis's hand, he has a small gift on behalf of the Board of Education to give you. And then, of course, you want to go over to Mrs. Johnson. She loves to give hugs, so expect it. I'm just warning you now. And then she has a certificate for you, too. When you come up to this stage here, after you receive your pin and your certificate and your hug, if you can stand in front of the table with your certificate out, because we'll have an opportunity for your parents to take a photograph of you for your memory book from this school year, okay? All right, so the Students of the Month program at Samuel Bissell Elementary School recognizes outstanding student achievement at the second and third grade levels. The focus of this recognition program is on citizenship, academics, social, civic, volunteer, or other accomplishments that set these students apart from their peers. We would like to proudly acknowledge the positive accomplishments of the following students. And we'll start with our second grade Tigers. First off, we have Hardy Chen from Ms. Conrad's class. Next, we have Kara Honecker from Miss Jolly's class. Next is Asher Keith from Mr. Harrison's class. Next, we have Christian Moore from Ms. King's class. Next is Caitlin Nowak from Ms. Conrad's class. Our next student is Brianna Robinson from Mrs. Labus and Ms. Wortman's class. And our last second grader, but not the least one, is Jackson Burge from Ms. Jolly's class. So now we're going to move up to our big kids, our third graders. And the first third grader to be recognized is Jonice Cornelius from Mrs. Cardaman's class. Next, we have Caitlin Paradise from Mrs. Kinsella's class. Next, we have Grace Sterlikar from Mrs. Dorland's class. And then finally, we have Ishan Tarari from Mr. Dolaresco's class. We are so very proud of our Samuel Bissell Elementary School Students of the Month from this month. And so boys and girls, if you could put your certificate forward and right in front of you like this, because your moms and dads would like to take a nice picture of you and your very, very best tiger smiles right now. Let's give these wonderful students one more round of applause.
Nice job, boys and girls. I'm so proud of you, and I can't wait till Friday when we have our lunch together, and we're going to have a good time playing some games and eating some pizza. So congratulations to you all. Can we give them a round of applause as they go back to their seats? Great job, boys and girls. You can head back to your seats. If I can have Mrs. Turk and Mrs. Andrews come forward, please, for our staff of the month. And as these ladies come forward, just to let you know a little bit of their background, they work with many of our students in different capacities throughout the school year. They are intervention assistants in our building, and they work with both grade levels, and they work very hard and do a very nice job working with our students. And for the staff of the month, other staff members nominate the staff, and so then this is how they are selected as staff of the month. So just to hear a little bit about what their colleagues think of them. So this person says, it was Mrs. Anderson, I wanted to nominate both Carrie and Karen as staff of the month. Since starting here as a substitute, both of these ladies have stepped in with patience to help me learn the new role as a full-time employee. They have never turned away when I've had questions, needed to be shown something, or needed materials to start working with. They are extremely resourceful, and I tell you, they really are. They go out and they look for the best things that they can use with, as far as manipulatives and ideas and strategies when working with students. So I appreciate their hard work. But let's get back to what they're saying. They are extremely resourceful individuals who lead by dignified example based on their years of experience accommodating our students. They make a point to bring to my attention any new implementations or procedures that come along so that I am starting off on my best foot each day. So one of the things, well, many of the things that they do in terms of working with our students, they pull them in small group and they give them extra intervention. And so they are always collaborating with the teacher, they're always collaborating with each other and coming up with the best ideas. So for that, we appreciate all the work that you do. So congratulations for Staff of the Month. Congratulations, Mrs. Turk and Mrs. Andrews. So we have a group of second grade students that are going to present to you this evening. So at this time, they're going to come over and they're going to set up some projects that they have worked on in Ms. Belinsky's class. Ms. Belinsky is a second grade teacher, and I'll help them get all set up. But they are so excited to share with you some of the things they have learned in class. And thank you so much, Ms. Rathbone, for all your help and helping to get this organized. Ms. Belinsky was sick this evening, so she's not here with us. But we'll help them get set up if you give us just a minute, and we'll get started. So as they continue to get set up, just to give you just a little bit of information, because I don't want to steal their thunder, these students worked on an economic unit, and they learned about entrepreneurship. So pay attention to some of the wording that you will see on their display, and then listen very carefully as they explain to you what they actually did in class. So boys and girls, when I hand the microphone to you, or I can help you hold the microphone too, say your first and last name first. Before you begin. And also, as they're speaking, Ms. Belinsky put together a PowerPoint to show. So we'll be doing two things, looking at the PowerPoint as well as listening to our students present today.
Hi, my name is Gavin Rathbone, and I want to welcome everybody that is here tonight, especially the first people that are here. And I want to welcome them here to the Board of Education. Congrats to all six people that are here, including myself. So I'm going to hand it off to Madeline Grannell.
Window shopping. Everybody got 10 smiley face stickers, and we all got in a long line from the front of the room to the back of the room. Then we used 10 smiley face stickers to put on any store on the interest inventory sign. If there were more, 10 or more smiley face stickers on the store, the owner knew the supply was low, but the demand was high, so they would have to raise their price on their products. If there was less than 10 smiley face stickers on the store, the owner knew that the supply is high, but the demand was low, so they would have to lower their price on their products.
Brody Minard, actual shopping. We lined up like a snake to buy our products using our $12. When we would buy our products, we crossed out many dollars bills it cost. While shopping, the owners of the shop would talk to us to get us to buy their product. Then we put our products in a plastic bag by our seats. The owner would tell us that we hoped we come back to their store.
Lila Wilson.
Clothes shop. All sold out. After a shop ran out of products, the owner of the shop would turn the sign around from open to closed. There were a total of 8 shops that closed at the end of our shopping trip.
AJ Cerise. Bartering and trading. So at the end of shopping, we all circled up in the room, and then we looked at all the products the owners had left. For example, if I had one sharp product left, and I saw another student had some products left, I might ask him to trade my last shark with one of his products.
Alexis Weber, customer feedback. Miss Belinsky gave us each 2 cards to write notes about 2 of our favorite products. Some comments were about the owner being friendly and courteous. Some people talked about the product and how much they liked it. We hope that you liked hearing all about our economic marketplace projects. We had a lot of fun shopping and learning all about economics.
Excellent job, students. And if you listen very carefully, these students learn so much about economics. If you listen, you would have heard words like trade and bartering and shopping, and you may have heard interest inventory and supply and demand. So you may have heard a lot of things associated with economics, and this is exactly what the students did, and they were able to make their own whatever they wanted to sell, their merchandise, and put it on display. So they did such an excellent job, and I was so proud of them. And it was funny when they set up, could you go back to the slide that shows the classroom where it looks like the snake that she was referring to? And you can get an idea. So they set up all of their displays on the desk. There we go. Thank you. And they were able to shop by walking by the desk and looking at what everyone, all of the other displays, and then deciding whether or not they were interested in that. So it was a very, very well thought out project. The students did a very nice job, as you can see from the displays that are here today. And I just wanted to tell you guys, you did such a great job, and thank you for coming tonight, and so proud of the work that you put forth in that economics unit during that lesson. So great job to you all. Can we give them another round of applause?
Boys and girls, that was a fabulous project, and I know Miss Belinsky is always looking for the next thing to do to add excitement to her classroom. So we thank her very much. I'm sorry she's not able to be here with us this evening, but boys and girls, you please let her know how proud we were of you and of your displays and of your good thinking and your great reading this evening. And Mrs. Johnson, as always, you bring a lot of excitement to our board meetings, and we do appreciate that. One more round of applause for Ms. Belinsky's students. All right, so now we're going to shift gears a little bit, and we're going to head down the street to R.B. Chamberlain Middle School, where we have great middle school students to celebrate this evening. And Mr. King is here tonight, our assistant principal from our middle school. Students receiving the honor of Student of the Month from R.B. Chamberlain Middle School are recognized for meeting all 6 of the criteria that I'm going to read. And each student has to meet all 6 criteria in all of their classes as the grade level teams decide upon 2 boys and 2 girls to be selected each month from each grade. And here are the criteria that the students have to meet. They have to show respect and consideration for others, show enthusiasm for academic and extracurricular activities, exert a positive influence on classmates, exhibit leadership characteristics, exhibit patriotism and democratic principles, and show responsibility such as reporting to school on time and having all of their work done. So the following students have been selected this month by their respective teaching teams at R.B. Chamberlain Middle School, and the students of the month for February are as follows. And we'll begin with our seventh grade students. Kayla Thompson, Nicholas Dobert, Kaylin Walker, Carly Genova, and Nathan Shiopada. Shiopada, so sorry. I should know better. Now moving on to our eighth grade students, we have Molly Rush, Ian Kirtley, Destiny Holt, and Xavier Branch. And students, I know that your families are here and would love to take a photo of you, so if you could hold your certificates in front of you. And your very proudest smiles there. We are so very proud of our R.B. Chamberlain Middle School Tigers. Please, let's give them one more round of applause.
Once you're done, you can go ahead and have a seat again. Congratulations, and thank you very much. Our piece at Chamberlain will be next Wednesday. No offense to the elementaries, but ours is a little better. Don't ask why, we just say it's better. At R.B. Chamberlain, just a few highlights I'd like to talk about, or just to make sure that we have some dates. The eighth grade Washington, D.C. trip, we are about at the red line for registration. We are pretty much there, as a matter of fact, so if you are considering going, now is the time. Get a hold of us right away and we could probably still get you in, but another week or two and we won't be able to do that. Seventh graders, we will be visiting Cedar Point in May. That registration is coming up. We have yet to hold that. We do that after the third 9 weeks is over and as we prepare for the fourth 9 weeks. Talking about spring and blooms coming up, if you come by Chamberlain, a definite sign of spring is spring sports. Baseball open hits this week. We had 45 young men come out for open hits. That's one of the larger groups we've seen. For track and field, I sat in on their informational meeting. There were approximately, this is some fuzzy math, so I apologize if it's not exact. My guess is around 200 students that came out to get information about track and field. It was very impressive. And this was, you need to be interested. Not just come along and grab a form, smile. No. This is, you're interested. You're going to come, you're going to work out, and take a look at what the program holds. Aside from that, we also have our spring play coming up. Willy Wonka is very exciting. I wanted to be at Oompa Loompa. They told me I was very Oompa Loompa-ish, but a little too big. But we did have 54 students come and try out for various roles. And Ms. Bennett, our director, said she saw something in every single student that came. So she made a role for every single student that came. No student was dropped from the play. And she expanded the play a lot. And what I mean by a lot, I'm not going to tell you how many roles there were originally, but she worked incredibly hard to make sure that was a very inclusive play. And that is not including the number of students that are going to volunteer for backstage, lighting, so on and so forth. So we have a great group that are going to be putting out a play, which will be coming up in April. We are very excited, and I know we're talking about a lot of spring. We're doing a lot of planning already for next year as well. Eighth grade have already entered their schedules, or at least their requests. Seventh grade, please don't feel like you're left out. We are going to be doing that very soon. Again, we want to kind of see where some of the MAP testing scores and some of the third quarter grades fall out, just to make sure that we are helping your students make the best choices possible for the upcoming eighth grade year. I believe somebody mentioned, who mentioned the Friday basketball game? Okay. Now, show of hands, who's playing in it?
I think Mr. Hanks.
Okay. I'm not allowed anymore.
Ms. Powers, you know, she won the slam the three-point conference last year, but, you know. Anyways, please come out. It's going to be a lot of fun. I can't promise a lot of scoring on my end. I may promise you a pulled hamstring, but it's going to be a lot of fun. A lot of great people are going to be out there for a great cause, which ends up being our students and giving them the best possible education. Again, the game is Friday, 7 o'clock at the high school. It would be a great time.
Thanks, Mr. King. Always exciting at the middle school. Mr. Curtis, that concludes my report for this evening.
Thank you, Mrs. Powers. always going to say it, that the favorite part of the evening for me is student recognitions and staff recognitions. I see you are already getting up to leave, so I'll say that for those that want to stay, you're more than welcome to stay and for the rest of our business meeting. Thank you.
It's quiet.
Okay. Okay, so we'll move on to committee reports. Do we have any committee reports?
Yeah, we had a buildings and grounds meeting this morning. Some of the topics that we covered was the lobby guard, which is in all of our welcome centers. It's the computers that visitors check in with, and we did do some modifications to the screens themselves, so when people are checking in, it's a little bit easier as far as scanning their license and so on. So there was an upgrade to that. We're still in the process of finalizing all of our sponsors for the scoreboards, just about complete, and looking forward to having those hopefully up in place for next seasons. Our FMX system is the way in which we do all of our repairs. So if there's something broken within the classroom or anywhere in the school facilities, it's entered into a computer system, which is then identified by our individuals that take care of that, and then they complete the project, and then it lets us know that what the project was and when it was completed, and it's a good way of tracking what's needed in the schools. And then additionally, we are looking at hopefully approving tonight some school bus purchases and a van. Our fleet is constantly rotating every about 10 years or so. So we purchase buses every year so that we have a fleet of buses that are in they're well maintained, and we don't have any buses that are extremely old or out of service. And also Chad went over some of the summer repairs and projects that are going to be happening. Typically in the summer we do a lot of any of our roofing and paving projects, so he's going over all of those, so anything like that. And then there's some other things coming up, like our, you know, our stage in the auditorium. We're going to be doing some repairs to that, and just a lot of housekeeping and general maintenance things on like windows and doors and things like that. I think I got everything.
All right, that's got a lot going on in buildings and grounds. Any other committee reports?
Finance met Monday morning, just to kind of go over some ongoing work in our committee on building use fees and revenue sharing agreement. No recommendations at this time. Continuing to watch the dollars coming in and making sure we're spending wisely and ensuring for the future of the district. And when we have some recommendations to bring forth to the board, we will do so.
Okay, anything else? All right, great. We'll move on to item F, remonstrance. Mr. Aho, do we have any cards?
No cards.
All right. So then we will keep this train moving. Item G, treasurer's report and recommendations. Without objection from my colleagues, I will read G 1 through 3 altogether. Excuse me. Resolved that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the following meeting minutes, regular meeting of February 15, 2017, as sent to the board under separate cover. 2, that the Twinsburg Board of Education accepts the following financial reports for the month of January 2017, bank reconciliation, general fund, financial summary report, and financial report by fund, as sent to the board under separate cover. And 3, that the Twinsburg Board of Education accepts the check register for the month of January 2017. The total, including payroll, is $3,887,950.57. Do I have a motion to approve G1 through 3?
So moved.
So moved by Mr. Felber. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mrs. Davis. Any discussion? Marty, is there anything that you would expound on with this?
These are pretty typical items, so nothing out of the usual.
Okay. Any other comments? Okay, hearing none. Mr. Aho, would you please call the roll?
Mr. Felber?
Yes.
Mrs. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Turl Waldron?
Yes.
Mr. Solura?
Yes.
Mr. Curtis?
Yes. Okay, item passes 5-0. Next is H, action items. Without objection from my colleagues, I will read H 1 through 3, excuse me, all together. H 1, resolved that the Twinsburg Board of Education accepts the certificated license personnel and or contract recommendations detailed in the attached exhibit as per the dates, terms, and other applicable conditions specified pending satisfactory ORC background checked. 2, that the Twinsburg Board of Education accepts the classified personnel and or contract recommendations detailed in the attached exhibit as per dates, terms, and other applicable conditions specified pending satisfactory ORC background check. And 3, that the Twinsburg Board of Education accepts the supplemental contract recommendations detailed in the attached exhibit as per the dates, terms, and other applicable conditions specified pending satisfactory ORC background checks. Do I have a motion to accept H 1 through 3?
So moved.
So moved by Mr. Soluro. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Felber. Any discussion? Hearing none, Mr. Aho, would you please call the roll?
Mr. Solura?
Yes.
Mr. Felber?
Yes.
Mrs. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Turl Waldron?
Yes.
Mr. Curtis?
Yes. That item passes 5-0. Okay, next is I 1 through 12. Without objection from my colleagues, I will read items 1 through 12 all together.
Can you separate I 4 from that, please?
Okay, I-4 will stand alone.
Thank you.
Need a motion.
To separate I-4 from...
I don't know
from
if you need a motion for that.
Okay.
You can just do it.
Okay. Thank you. Okay.
All right, we'll go items I-1 through 3 read together. I-1, resolve that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the donation for Ohio Pile Prints Incorporated, 410 Dinner Bell Road, Ohio Pile, PA, 15470 to Twinsburg High School in the amount of $31.16 to be used for miscellaneous instructional supplies per the attached exhibit. 2, that the Twinsburg Board of Education accepts the donation from Target 1 Scholarship Way, St. Peter, Minnesota, 56082, Scholarship America Field Trips Grant Program in the amount of $700 to be used to cover the expenses for field trip to the Great Lakes Science Center for Wilcox Primary Kindergarten students per the attached exhibit. And 3, excuse me, that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the attached listing of medium center items to be deleted from inventory per the attached exhibit. Do I have a motion to accept items I, 1 through 3?
So moved.
So moved by Mrs. Davis. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mrs. Turl Waldron. Discussion? Hearing none. Mr. Aho, would you please call the roll?
Mrs. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Turl Waldron?
Yes.
Mr. Felber?
Yes.
Mr. Salura?
Yes.
Mr. Curtis?
Yes. Okay, items I-1 through 3 passes 5-0. Okay, I will continue on, excuse me, with item I-4. Resolve that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the contract with Patricia Coslow for independent public relations consulting services from July 1, 2017 through June 30th, 2018 at an hourly rate of $55 per hour, not to exceed 960 hours as sent to the board under separate cover. Do I have a motion to approve I-4?
So moved.
So moved by Mrs. Salura. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Felber. Discussion?
I just want to discuss Mrs. Coslow does an exceptional job and does a lot of coverage for us. Just at this time, I'm concerned. I know her contract would not start until July. So with some of the obligations we have on the table, I'm just not comfortable at this time. So I guess, I just wanted to put that out there that I do believe that she's an asset, but I wanted to, while we have some of our expenditures coming up and with the levy and such, I until we know for sure or what direction that turns out, I think we need to watch our pennies. And that's it.
Any other comments? Okay, hearing none, Mr. Aho, would you please call the roll?
Mr. Salura?
Yes.
Mr. Felber?
Yes.
Mrs. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Turl Waldron?
No.
Mr. Curtis?
Yes. Excuse me, item passes 4-1. Okay, moving on to items I-5 through 12. Without objections from my colleagues, I will read items 5 through 12 together. Items 5, resolve that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the Summit County Interagency Agreement with each school district is required to have in place with the local Board of Developmental Disabilities Head Start and Help Me Grow program as defined in the operating standards for Ohio schools serving children with disabilities as sent to the board under separate cover. 6, that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the lease agreement 2017 between Twins Days Incorporated and the Twinsburg City School District as sent to the board under separate cover. 7, resolve that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the superintendent's agreement for, excuse me, 1 student to attend Kinston Local Schools for the remainder of the 16-17 school year as sent to the board under separate cover. 8, that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the proposal for an overnight extended student trip for the Twinsburg High School Great Expectations Show Choir to travel to Wheaton, Illinois for the Wheaton-Warrensville South High School Show Choir Invitational on March 10, 2017 and returning on March 12, 2017. The cost of this trip is being paid in full by the Twinsburg Vocal Music Boosters as sent to the board under separate cover. 9, that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves a proposal for an overnight extended student trip for Dodge Intermediate School, sixth grade students to travel to Camp Fitch YMCA in North Springfield, Pennsylvania on May 18, 2017 and returning on May 19, 2017. The cost of this trip will be paid for by the students as sent to the board under separate cover. 10, that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves a proposal for an overnight extended student trip for one Twinsburg High School student to participate in the OHSAA State Girls Bowling Tournament in Columbus, Ohio from Thursday, March 9th, 2017 through Friday, March 10th, 2017. The cost of this trip will be paid for by the athletic department budget with support from the Twinsburg Athletic Boosters as sent to the board under separate cover. 11, that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves a service agreement with the Education Alternatives for the purpose of placing a child in an alternative educational setting for the provision of a free appropriate public education, FAPE. The student will attend on February 8, 2017 for the remainder of the 2016-17 school year at a cost of $3,150. This is a general fund expense as sent to the board under separate cover. And 12, that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the employment agreement for the superintendent of schools commencing August 1st, 2017 and expiring July 31st, 2020 as sent to the board under separate cover. I have a motion to approve I-6, 5 through 12.
So moved.
So moved by Mr. Felber. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Solura. Let's see, let me go back. Make sure that cover these things. Just want to make mention of the education alternatives. I know that we've done this in the past, Mrs. Powers, with students with disabilities that require a little bit more than what we're able to do here in the district. So education alternatives will be providing services for that student. Is there anything else that you would add in that circumstance?
No, that is correct. We need to provide a student with free appropriate public education, and we recognize the fact that sometimes students have disabilities for which an alternative placement would be better suited for his particular needs. And so that is the recommendation this evening for a contract to support the student attending educational alternatives.
Okay. And also, with regard to item 12 of the agenda, by state statute, we as a board are bound to take action on the superintendent's contract by today's date. And as such, we've been able to negotiate a fair contract, which keeps her in our school district for 3 years. And I personally have enjoyed working with Mrs. Powers and look forward to continuing our work in delivering high-quality curriculum and programs to our students. And, you know, having a high school that's ranked in the top 5% in the country, we got a new academy that's going to be up and running in the fall, nationally recognized Blue Ribbon School. All of that is evidence of what's possible when you have good leadership. So although we've got a lot of work to do, a lot of hard work that's ahead of us, your unwavering support, your unwavering commitment to our district hasn't gone unnoticed, and I personally, it's much appreciated.
Thank you, Mr. Curtis.
Any other comments?
Sure. I know that Mrs. Powers puts in a lot of work for our schools, and very hard pressed to find somebody who would put in as much time, energy, and effort, and I'm sure it's exhausting, and I'm not a position I think I'd want to be put in. And I know as a community member, has a vested interest in our schools and our kids, and I look forward over the next few years of just continued growth, strong relations with our community, our staff, and most importantly with our children, and doing what's best for our children.
Thank you, Mrs. Davis.
Mr. Curtis, I would echo, for those of us that only get a glimpse of Mrs. Powers here or there between buildings, for the five of us and the rest of the administrators up here, we see the day-to-day. There's tons of communication that goes on, tons of decisions. The school board does not make just the decisions that you hear about in a public meeting. There's many, many committee meetings that go on, and I would echo what's already been said, the dedication The thoughtfulness, the intelligence that's brought to this district, whether it's reviewing a contract or looking at a curriculum plan, or just looking at a new way to bring students up on a grade point and bring the programs such as our academic coaches to light. One of the first big decisions that three of the five of us made when we were new board members. So with that, I would echo the rest of the comments that my colleagues have said.
Thank you, Mr. Felber.
As I've learned, it is not always oftentimes a thankless job. A lot of times, decisions that get made, you can never please everybody. But in my time here, I know that every decision that you make has the kids' best interest at heart. And ultimately, that's why you're here, that's why we're here, that's why our staff is here. And I appreciate the time. Multiple people continue to tell me that, Kathy Powers is everywhere, and sometimes wonder if you have a twin floating around. So I do appreciate it. I think it's very important, also that you're a community member, because I think that creates an extra tie to the district that, I think our district is fortunate to have that. And I appreciate my fellow board members in the due diligence that we have done, in thoroughly, believing that we have the best candidate here, and holding and keeping you here for the next 3 years. So I appreciate what you've done and your time here, and I look forward to things to come in the next 3 years. So thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Slora.
Mr. Aho, would you please call the roll?
Mr. Felber?
Yes.
Mr. Solora?
Yes.
Mrs. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Turl Waldron?
No.
Mr. Curtis?
Yes. And that passes 4-1. Moving on to I-13 and 14, without objection from my colleagues, I'll read both together. 13, resolved that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the purchase of 3 stock unit 72 passenger buses at the total cost of $247,375 pursuant to the terms and conditions set forth in the proposal sent to the board under separate cover. These buses will be purchased through the Ohio Schools Council bid secured for the 2016-17 school year from Cardinal Bus Sales and Service Incorporated, 6280 Harding Highway, State Route 309, Lima, Ohio 45801. This is a permanent improvement expenditure. And 14, that the Twinsburg Board of Education approves the purchase of 1 2017 Ford Transit passenger van through the Ohio Schools Council bid secured for the 15-16 school year at a cost of $27,131.50. The van will be purchased from Ganley Ford Incorporated, 2835 Barber Road, Norton, Ohio, 44203. This is a permanent improvement expenditure. Do I have a motion for I-13-14?
So moved.
So moved by Mrs. Turl Waldron. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Solora. Any discussion, anything that you would add, or any background, Chad, or anybody from the buildings and grounds?
Mr. Welker, if you want to take the lead on that.
Sure. The bus purchase, we've been able to secure price protection for the buses. This is the second year in a row we've done that. So last year, by using that methodology of being able to secure it based on the previous year's bid, we were able to save a little under $8,000 with the purchase. So our hope is that would continue, but the contract also has a price protection that if for some reason the bids come in lower, which I don't anticipate, but if they do, they'll credit us the difference. So we have price protection in both ways. With the van purchase, we're able to utilize a previous bid as well and get a very attractive price for a passenger van to handle more of our smaller transportation runs. So those are the two items on the agenda for your consideration here.
Thank you, thank you. Any other discussion? Okay, hearing none, Mr. Aho, would you please call the roll?
Mrs. Turl Waldron?
Yes.
Mr. Solura?
Yes.
Mrs. Davis?
Yes.
Mr. Felber?
Yes.
Mr. Curtis?
Yes. And that item passes 5-0. Next on the agenda is miscellaneous. I was remiss in commenting during I of the donations, one from Ohio Pile Prints and also Target. Always want to make sure that I acknowledge our appreciation for any donations to our school district for whatever purposes. They always help in our endeavors to provide quality education to our students and also support for our staff. So I wanted to make sure I acknowledge that.
Real quick, and you kind of hit on it in your report, Mr. Curtis, as well as Superintendent Powers when he stole it from you. I had the pleasure to be in attendance at Mark Wood. And as somebody who has a child in orchestra, was absolutely blown away, not only at the performance itself and his talent, but just the joy on the faces, I think, was the thing that I took away the most of the kids that were up there. We had some students who were fortunate enough to play some of his own instruments in the front row, and I think for the entire 2 hours of the concert, there were smiles that ear to ear that didn't stop. The excitement of these kids, and I've been to multiple orchestra concerts, and the kids are always good, and they're always enjoyable. But you know, this was just an extraordinary event. I want to thank, you know, that on multiple levels is what it took to get that. One, you know, Mr. Kahn, who prepares those kids and it really instills in them the joy of playing. You know, the Orchestra Boosters, just another tremendous organization, just another example of the tremendous support that we have from our parents and community with these organizations to be able to put that on. Administration and staff that work so hard to get that place up and going, and you know, the sponsors and there was a production company that actually brought in extra things, extra lighting, all at no charge, just to help put this on. It was broadcast, or it was taped by Cable 9. I'm not too sure when it airs, but I will definitely be looking for that. And as I also believe that the Orchestra Boosters will be putting out a video DVD, Blu-ray of some sort here. So I truly, if you haven't seen it, it's definitely worth seeing. And I thank everybody, and you know, to what Mr. Woods said there, a district is a lot of things, but you can really tell a district by how well it supports. One of the things that you can't really grade, you don't see on a report card, is how well you support the arts. And the amount of people that from the community that turned out, you know, and you know, just the support that the district continues to show, and that the community continues to show, was really good, and was just very happy with that. And once in a lifetime, it was amazing. So I was glad that my child was able to participate in it, and that I was able to be there and see it. So thank you.
I would add, Mark Wood, ditto. Everything he said, that was amazing. Obviously, you know, March 1st came in like a tiger, and some might be lamenting, you know, hey, you know, it's a two-hour delay. You can sort of know when snow's coming. You can't know when a tornado's coming. But no, besides being woken up and handling this crisis, as always, Mrs. Powers, I do know that her first duty was to secure and make sure the staff was safe. Those that are pre-flighting buses, those are already in our buildings, even before she had a chance to go to the two-hour delay. So I wanted to thank you for that. I imagine staff's all over the building, and you know, just thinking of their welfare first when we're getting texts in the morning, hey, we're going on a two-hour delay. You know, kids enjoyed it. But you know, you can't predict that weather, especially the tornadoes. So thank you for making sure that they were safe first, and then letting the families know.
You're welcome.
Anything else?
Board of Education, I just want to thank you for the support that you give me as the district superintendent. Obviously, I'm just one of many that make things happen here. I have an awesome administrative team
an awesome teaching staff, an awesome support staff that make it happen every day where the rubber hits the road, and that's in our classrooms, and making sure that our buildings are warm, safe, and dry. It's a tremendous organization. I'm proud to be affiliated with it. And my husband, Paul, who is here this evening in support of what I do here, understands the work that I do and is supportive making sure that the Twinsburg City School District gets the very best. So appreciate you being here tonight, Paul. And I do appreciate the support that you offer to me. The next 3 years, goodness knows what curveballs we'll receive from Columbus and DC. But just know that the staff is here to support our kids. And, you know, I wasn't just kidding this evening when I was explaining. Just in 1 week's time, all that has happened here, things, programs, activities, opportunities for our students. On Friday of this week, we will host the Twinsburg Chamber, and we are going to be kicking off for next school year our Academy program. And all these things happen because a Board of Education, you employ outstanding individuals who support what happens here every day. So thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to be here for the next 3 years. I look forward to that excitement, and I do appreciate your support.
Any other comments?
Good luck to our children that are going to be traveling over the next few weekends. Our show choir, they're just amazing, and good luck on their trip on March 10th. Also, all of our athletes, our wrestlers that are going to be traveling for their tournament, our bowling team, our bowling individual traveling down to Columbus, and then I know our girls basketball team has that big game, and they always do a really nice job. So best of luck to coach and athletes.
Okay, and one final note for last night. Yeah, for the African American program, I did have the privilege of being there, and it was my first time. Been hearing about all the good things, and I was able to witness the program, and really, wow! I mean, I couldn't believe how many students participated in the program and took on leadership positions and getting it done, all the way from lights, stage, sound, you name it, they were the ones behind the scenes getting it all done. Kudos also to the jazz band. Wow. I mean, I felt like I was in a club, you know, back in the 50s. You know, the videos, the spoken word, there was a choir that I guess it was a mini choir. It wasn't really like a full choir, but they sounded like a choir. Students dancing, stepping, you name it. I mean, they went from, you know, they really spanned a large swath of not only African-American history, but American history. We have to really understand and acknowledge the fact that this is American history. I thought they did a phenomenal job. It was very evident and clear how much time and effort they put into this process and this program. And so I enjoyed every bit of it, and I do intend on continuing to attend. I was told that this year was the biggest year in the way of student participation that they've ever had. So it was very evident to me, and it'll probably be twice as many kids going into next year. So I wanted to make sure that I acknowledged, really get a pat on the back from the staff, but more importantly, the students that pulled it off. I was thoroughly impressed. Okay. No more comments. We will move on to item K. We do have a need to go into executive session. You'll have a motion to go into executive session. So moved by Mr. Felber. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Salura. Okay, so the board will enter into executive session at 8:10 p.m. to discuss employment and compensation of public employees as per the Board of Education Policy 0166A. I do not think that we'll have a need to reconvene for further business. Mr. Aho, would you please call the roll?
Mr. Felber?
Yes.
Mr. Salura?
Yes.
Mrs. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Turr-Waldron?
Yes.
Mr. Curtis?
Yes. Okay, 5-0. We are now in executive session.